with all my students in Industrial Electronics Laboratory. Today we are going to familiarize ourselves with relays, which is our experiment one. Now let us discuss firstly the single pole, single throw, normally open relay, which is shown in this figure. Okay. Now, as you can see, there are two boxes. The left box is the normal position, and the right box is the active position. Okay. Now, normal position in the sense that there is no voltage applied yet to the relay coil. Active position, if there is already a voltage source applied to the relay coil. Okay. Now this is our single pole, single throw, normally open, because the position of the auxiliary contact or the relay contact is open. This is the normal position here. As you energize the relay, this normally open contact closes, thereby energizing our load. If you de-energize the relay, you will go back to the normal position. Now let me show you simulation for this single pole, single throw, normally open. Before we go to the simulation, let us go to the single pole, single throw, normally closed contact relay. So the difference is that the normal position, the contact, the relay contact or the auxiliary contact is already closed. Normally, it's closed. Unlike here, it is open. So when at normal position, since this is a closed contact, auxiliary contact, then the load is energized at normal position. When you energize the relay at active position, the relay contact opens, thereby de-energizing our load. So this is actually the opposite of the normally open contact. Okay, the normal position is normally open. Here it's normally closed. But as you energize the relay coil, the contacts open or closes depending on the normal position. Okay, so let's go to our simulation. So we'll be using a Festo fluid sim. Okay, so here is our load control circuit, rather. This is our load circuit. So this is the relay here, and this is our 24 volt source. This is our ground. So this is our push button, which is normally open. So when we press this one, the relay will be energized and we will observe its the behavior of its contact. So we have here the normally open and the normally closed contact. So I just simulate it together in order for you to see the difference between the two operation. So if we run this simulation, as you can see, the normally closed contact, even at normal position, the load, which is our, which is the lamp, is already energized. Okay, even though we have not yet energized the relay, since this is already a normally closed contact, this is already a closed circuit, the red line. So if we press the push button, as you can see, the normally open contact, normally closed contact opens, de-energizing the lamp. At the same time, the normally open contact closes, energizing the other lamp. Okay, so if we release the push button, the normally open contact goes back to normal position, and the normally closed contact goes back to normal position, thereby energizing again the lamp. Okay, so if we press normally open contact close, energizing the lamp. If we release it, it de-energizes. Below, the normally closed contact energizes the lamp. Okay, so this is how the single pole single throw relay works. Okay, so let's now go to the single pole double throw relay. Okay, so as you can see the difference, this is one common terminal, that's why we call it single pole. There are two switching positions. Okay, that's why we call it double throw. So this is the normal position, this is the active position. Okay, there are two switching positions. Okay, so if we, this is the normal position, so as you can see, the fan one, which is our load, is energized because this is a complete circuit. As we energize the relay, the switching position transfers to 2, thereby de-energizing fan 1 and energizing fan 2. If we de-energize the relay, it will go back to the normal position. Okay, so let me show you simulation for this one. So let me choose single pole double throw. Okay, so this is our control circuit, this is our load circuit. So this is the two switching positions here. So this is the normal position and this is the active position here. So as we run the simulation, obviously at the normal position, the green lamp is energized. Okay, even though the relay is not yet energized. So if we press the push button, so the yellow lamp is energized. If we release, it goes back to its normal switching position. If we push again, then active position and release. So that's how single pole double throw relay works. Okay. Then we go to normally open double pole single throw relay. Okay. So this is double pole because there are two common terminals. This may not be common, but there are two terminals and there is only one switching position. Okay, so this is normally open. So again, this is the left side of the box. This is the normal position. This is the active position when the 12-volt source is applied to the relay. By the way, there are also 24-volt, 48-volt relay and so on. Okay, there could also be 5-volt relay, depending on the kind of relay that you have. Okay, so here normal position, since these are normally open, our two loads, the lamp and the fan, is not yet energized. Okay, at active position, the two relay contacts close, thereby energizing our load. Okay, so that's how a double pole single throw normally open relay. On the other hand, we also have a double pole single throw normally close. Okay, the normal position, the two relay contacts are rather normally close. So initially the two loads are energized, As you activate, energize the relay, the two contacts open, de-energizing our loads. Okay? So let me show you again simulation for this one. So let me show you double pole, single throw, normally open. So this is our double pole, single throw. So this is our control circuit. This is our load circuit. This is normally open, the two auxiliary contacts. Okay, so as you energize, press the push button, the relay is energized, the two contacts close, thereby energizing the two lamps. We release, the relay coil is de-energized, and the two relay contacts go back to normal position. Okay, so push button, release. Okay, so that's how double pole single throw operates. Then we go to double pole double throw. So two terminals, and there are two switching positions. Okay, so this is the normal position that it energized the coil. This is the active position when the coil is already energized. So from switching position one, when activated, the contacts go to switching position 2 and 4. Okay, so this is switching position 1 and 3, the normal position. Then as you activate, the contacts go to normal switching position 2 and 4. So this is applicable in if this is our motor at normal position, it's rotating counterclockwise. As you activate or energize the relay, as the switching position transfers to 2 and 4, the motor now reverses to clockwise rotation, clockwise direction. Okay? So let me show you the simulation for this one. So you have double pole, double throw. Let me show first the double pole single throw, normally close. So this is normally close. We have normally open before this one. So as we run the simulation, initially the lamps are energized, okay, because these are normally closed contacts, even if the relay is not yet energized. So as we push the button, de-energizing the lamps because the two contacts open. As you release, the lamps are energized again. Okay. So for the double pole double throw, so we have here two switching positions. These are the normal position here. So as we run the simulation, these two lamps are initially energized. Okay. As you press the button, the other loads are energized. Okay. As you release, goes back to normal position. So the green and the yellow lamps are energized. As we push the button, the purple and the blue lamps are energized. So that's how a double pole double throw relay works. So for our next video, we will be discussing our second experiment.